Welcome to another adventure with Getting Lost. Today, we are actually at Hong Lim Complex. And Hong Lim Complex is well known for its food center here, which during lunchtime serves lots of hungry people. People come here and this place is packed, but there's a place nearby here that people don't know about. So let's go and explore it. Hong Lim Market and Food Center. It's a two-story food center and market. On the bottom floor, half of the stores are market stores, and the other stores are actually food stores, especially the second floor. And there's lots and lots of different variety of foods here. So you can come here. There's lots of different types of hawker food. And I'm sure many people who have been here are very familiar with all the different types of foods and stalls that are sold here. But did you know that not only are there there's not only a food center here, around the southern areas there's a lot of retail outlets, shops that sell different types of things, even offices. But what are we going to do now? We're going to go again, like our previous video. We actually went to the roof of a Chinatown complex. So what we're going to do now, we're actually going to go to the roof again of this place here, which is Hong Lim Food Center, and let's see what we can find on the roof. So basically what you need to do is you need to go and look for a lift, or you can walk. Okay, you can go all the way up here to the fifth floor. And on the fifth floor here, it's slightly different than what we found on Chinatown complex. It's more spread out, and there are also a bit of like community centers around here. So on the floor itself, there are actually offices which are parts of the community center. But what I do really like is you get a different view of the landscape. Okay, you see things differently. Okay, you see things from an elevated perspective. Like I said earlier, this place is slightly different because, as you can see, this place is more spread out, more different blocks in between this car park here. So these areas here are all connected by bridges, like overhead bridges that you see over there. You know, and all their facilities are also spread out. So at one corner will be the playground, another corner will be the exercise area, and of course we come here for the view. Anyway, like I said, the bridges, and of course, like I told you earlier, there are also offices here. These offices here are the offices for the community center that actually helps to look after the area here. And if we zoom in here, you can actually see Far East Plaza. No, Far East Square, not Plaza, Far East Square, where there's a lot of pre-World War II shop houses, and behind that, the CBD area. So like I said, there's a lot of walkways, covered walkways, and of course a lot of bridges that are connecting all the areas. And at one end of the Hong Lim complex, you'll find the playground. The playground itself is in front of the hotel Park Royal at Pickering. And this hotel itself is also a mixture of offices and hotel. As you can see, this is the area just in between the HDB block and the hotel is a playground. Why would you have that? And somehow it's an elevated playground, it's on top. No one knows it's here. As you can see, the facilities are quite new in a sense that it doesn't seem run down. And this is the hotel itself. And this is Chinatown Point Shopping Center. A few restaurants there and a few other things. There's also supermarkets, Anyway, so we have a playground here with things, and also a treehouse. How novel is it to have a treehouse on top of the roof of a HDB flat? And then you also have a worm and some rocking horses. Anyway, right at the end there is a exercise area where you can use to exercise it. And of course, it also doesn't look very old. It looks quite new. But just imagine, you're just in between all these tall buildings and HDB blocks, you have a recreational area here. Very secret, very hideaway, a place that not many people know of, which I'm discovering and exposing to you. As you can see, this is the floor, and then there's also, like I told you, retail shops, offices, and then residential on top. And I'm walking all the way to the other side here. Over this side here, you can actually see that you have a bigger view of Chinatown. All the roofs of the pre-World War II shophouses. Of course, you have a better view if you go to the top there. But from this elevated area, the view is also quite nice. Okay, let's get to the road itself. And let me show you some of the things that you can see from the road. Okay, at one corner, this is the Hornim complex that we are at now. This is the HDB flat on top of it. A small little garden. And if you look down here, this is South Bridge Road in front of China Square Shopping Center. And the bus itself is heading around South Beach Road. And this road itself here that we are looking at now is Cross Street. And it goes all the way right to the end there. There's a CBD area right in the background. And then now is the shop houses and the background pinnacles. The most biggest public housing area in the world. And then People's Park at the end there. And now we're again looking at South Beach Road. There again, the CBD area. And if you look further down along South Beach Road, you can actually see that they still have the Chinese New Year decorations up along the road itself. And from this side here, if you look down, we actually have a MRT exit. This is for the Chinatown MRT station. They actually have an exit here. You can exit out to come here. And if you walk further down, there's also another exercise area with the equipment here. And you bring you closer, right behind there is People's Park Complex, the yellow and green building. And this is Cross Street again. Doesn't it look interesting? Anyway, so this is the elevated view from Hornim Complex that you don't normally get to see when you're walking down on the ground. I find it very interesting and very picturesque and panoramic. Anyway, thank you very much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this unknown place that I found for you. Wasn't that interesting? Anyway, I guess you know what to do. Please like, share, and subscribe if you have not done so. And ask your friends and families to do the same. And the most important thing you need to do is come and join me for my next adventure. That's about all. Bye bye.